Every message as I lead this army, make room for mistakes and depression. And with that being said, my nigga, let me ask this question: when shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? When shit hit the fan, when shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? When shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? The ghost of Mandela, hope my flow stay propelling. Let these words be your earth and moon, you consume every message. As I lead this army, make room for mistakes and depression. And with that being said, my nigga, let me ask this question: when shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? When shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? Won't you look to your left and right, make sure you ask your friends. When shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? Do you believe in me? Are you deceiving me? Could I let you down easily? Is your heart where it need to be? Is your smile on permanent? Is your foul on lifetime? Would you know where the sermon is? If I died in this next line, if I'm tried in a court of law, if the industry cut me off, if the government want me dead, pack cocaine in my car, would you judge me a drug head? Or see me as Kay Lamar? Or question my character and degrade me on every block? Want you to love me like Nelson? Want you to hug me like Nelson? I freed you from being a slave in your mind, you're very welcome. You tell me my song is more than a song, it's surely a blessing. But a prophet ain't a prophet till he asks you this question: when shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? When shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? Won't you look to your left and right, make sure you ask your friends. When shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? The ghost of Mandela, hope my flow stay propelling. Let my word be your earth and moon, you consume every message. As I lead this army, make room for mistakes and depression. And with that, do you believe in me? How much you believe in her? You think she gon' stick around if them 25 years occur? You think he gon' hold you down when you down behind bars hurt? You think y'all on common ground if you promise to be there first? Can you be immortalized without your life being expired? Even though y'all share the same blood, is it worth the time? Like who got your best interest? Like how much are you dependent? How clutch are the people that say they love you and who pretended? How tough is your skin when they turn you in? Do you show forgiveness? What brush do you bend with dust in your shoulders from being offended? What kind of den did they put you in when the lions start hissing? And what kind of bridge do they burn revenge on your mind when it's mentioned? You wanna love like Nelson, you wanna be like Nelson. You wanna walk in his shoes, but your peacemaking seldom. You wanna be remembered and deliver the message that considered the blessing of everyone. This your lesson for everyone. Say when shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? When shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? Won't you look to your left and right, make sure you ask your friends. When shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? The voice of Mandela, hope this flow stay propelling. Let my word be your earth and moon, you consume every message. As I lead this army, make room for mistakes and depression. And if you riding with me, nigga, I've been wrote off before. I got abandonment issues, I hold grudges like bad judges. Don't let me resent you, that's not Nelson-like. Want you to love me like Nelson. I went to Robben Island analyzing, that's where his cell is, so I can find clarity. Like how much you cherish me. Is this relationship a fake or real as the heavens be? See, I gotta question it all. Family, friends, fans, cats, dogs, trees, plants, grass. How the wind blow, Murphy's Law, Generation X. Will I ever be your ex? Flaws of a baby step, marred by the mouth a bit. Pause, put me under stress, crawl under rocks, ducking y'all. It's respect, but then tomorrow, put my back against the wall. How many leaders you said you needed, then left them for dead? Is it Moses? Is it Huey Newton or Detroit Red? Is it Martin Luther, JFK shooter? You assassin? Is it Jackie? Is it Jesse? Oh, I know it's Michael Jackson. Oh, when shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? When shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? That nigga gave us Billie Jean. You say he touched those kids? When shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? The ghost of Mandela, hope my flow stay propelling. Let my word be your earth and moon, you consume every message. As I lead this army, make room for mistakes and depression. And if you ride with me, nigga, let me ask this question, nigga. I remember you was conflicted, misusing your influence. Sometimes I did the same, abusing my power full of resentment.
resentment that turned into a deep depression. Found myself screaming in the hotel room. I didn't want to self-destruct. The evils of Lucy was all around me. So I went running for answers until I came home. But that didn't stop survivor's guilt. Going back and forth trying to convince myself the stripes I earned. Or maybe how A1 my foundation was. But while my loved ones was fighting a continuous war back in the city, I was entering a new one. A war that was based on apartheid and discrimination. Made me want to go back to the city and tell the homies what I learned. The word was respect. Just because you wore a different gang color than mine's doesn't mean I can't respect you as a black man. Forgetting all the pain and hurt we caused each other in these streets. If I respect you, we unify and stop the enemy from killing us. But I don't know. I'm no mortal man. Maybe I'm just another nigga. Shit, and that's all I wrote. I was gonna call it another nigga, but it ain't really a poem. I just felt like it's something you probably could relate to. Other than that, now that I finally got a chance to holler at you, I always wanted to ask you about a certain situation, about a metaphor, actually. You spoke on the ground. What you mean by that? What the ground represent?
The ground is gonna open up and swallow the evil.
Right.
That's how I see it. My word is born. I see, and the ground is a symbol for the poor people.
Right.
The poor people is gonna open up this whole world and swallow up the rich people. Cause the rich people are gonna be so fat and they're gonna be so appetizing. You know what I'm saying? Wealthy, appetizing. The poor gonna be so poor and hungry.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be like, you know what I'm saying? It's gonna be, it might be some cannibalism out this month, but they might eat the rich. You know what I'm saying?
All right, so let me ask you this then. Do you see yourself as somebody that's rich or somebody that made the best of their own opportunities?
I see myself as a natural born hustler, a true hustler in every sense of the word. I took nothing, I took the opportunities. I worked at the most menial and degrading job and built myself up so I can get it to where I owned it. I went from having somebody manage me to me hiring the person that works my management company.
Right.
I changed everything. I realized my destiny in a matter of 5 years, you know what I'm saying? I made myself a millionaire.
Right.
I made millions for a lot of people. Now it's time to make millions for myself, you know what I'm saying? I made millions for the record companies. I made millions for these movie companies. Now we make millions for us.
And through your different avenues of success, how would you say you managed to keep a level of sanity?
By my faith in God, by my faith in the game, and by my faith in all good things come to those that stay true.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And it was happening to me for a reason. You know what I'm saying? I was noticing shit. I was punching the right buttons and it was happening. So it's no problem, you know. I mean, it's a problem, but I'm not finna let them know. I'm finna go straight through.
Would you consider yourself a fighter at heart, or somebody that only reacts when their back is against the wall?
Shit, I like to think that at every opportunity I've ever been threatened with resistance, it's been met with resistance. And not only me, but it goes down my family tree. You know what I'm saying? It's in my veins to fight back.
All right, well, how long you think it take before niggas be like, we fighting a war, I'm fighting a war, I can't win, and I want to lay it all down?
In this country, a black man only have like 5 years we can exhibit maximum strength. And that's right now, while you a teenager, while you still strong, while you still want to lift weights, while you still want to shoot back. Because once you turn 30, it's like they take the heart and soul out of a man, out of a black man in this country. And you don't want to fight no more. And if you don't believe me, you can look around. You don't see no loudmouth 30-year-old motherfuckers.
That's crazy. Because me being one of your offsprings of the legacy you left behind, I can truly tell you that it's nothing but turmoil going on. So I wanted to ask you, what you think is the future for me and my generation today?
I think that niggas is tired of grabbing shit out the stores, and next time it's a riot, it's gonna be like bloodshed, for real. I don't think America know that. I think America think we was just playing, it's gonna be some more playing, but it ain't gonna be no playing. It's gonna be murder. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be like Nat Turner, 1831, up in this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna happen.
That's crazy, man. In my opinion, only hope that we kind of have left is music and vibrations. A lot of people don't understand how important it is. You know, sometimes I can like get behind a mic and I don't know what type of energy I'm gonna push out or where it comes from. Trip me out sometimes.
Because it's spirits. We ain't even really rapping. We just letting our dead homies tell stories for us.
Yeah. I wanted to read one last thing to you. It's actually something a good friend had wrote describing my world. It says, the caterpillar is a prisoner to the streets that conceived it. Its only job is to eat or consume everything around it in order to protect itself from this mad city. While consuming this environment, the caterpillar begins to notice ways to survive. One thing it notices how much the world shuns him, but praises the butterfly. The butterfly represents the talent, the thoughtfulness, and the beauty within the caterpillar. But having a harsh outlook on life, the caterpillar sees the butterfly as weak and figures out a way to pimp it to its own benefits. Already surrounded by this mad city, the caterpillar goes to work on the cocoon, which institutionalizes him. He can no longer see past his own thoughts. He's trapped. While trapped inside these walls, certain ideas take root, such as going home and bringing back new concepts to this mad city. The result? Wings begin to emerge, breaking the cycle of feeling stagnant. Finally free, the butterfly sheds light on situations that the caterpillar never considered, ending the internal struggle. Although the butterfly and caterpillar are completely different, they are one and the same. What's your perspective on that? Pop. Pop.